Hi, this is Tim. Welcome to the MathLeague YouTube channel. Today we're going to be looking at team question number 5 from elementary school test 12125. This was given out in January and February of 2021. So we've got a magic square. All the rows, columns, and diagonals add up to the same thing. So we just need to figure out what the missing pieces are. Interestingly enough, we actually have enough information just from the entries that are already here to figure out what's going on. So what we want to do is identify squares that we can put information into. The first one I'm going to do is the top right square. Right? Now, the way we want to do this is to take a look at the row across the top and the first column. So the first row and the first column, I don't know what goes in this upper left corner, but it doesn't matter. It's something, right? And that something plus 21 plus 22 is going to be the same thing as that something plus 17 plus the top right corner. Now, if we ignore what goes in the top left, then what we have left over is 21 plus 22 equals 17 plus this thing. So let's write that down, right? 21 plus 22 equals 17 plus x, whatever that number is, right? So 21 plus 22 is 43. And if I subtract 17 from both sides, I get my x. 43 minus 17, of course, is 26. All right, so now we take a look at, we try to find some other situation where we can accomplish the same thing. What if, for instance, we took a look at the second column and the third row? Now, this piece right here, at the center of the bottom, is going to be the same in both sums, right? So this bottom center piece, plus 22 plus 19, is also going to equal the bottom center plus 17 plus this thing. We'll call that missing piece y, and we get 22 plus 19 equals 17 plus y. Now, y is the center square at this point. 22 plus 19 is going to be 41. And when we subtract 17 to get y, 41 minus 17 is going to give us a 24. Well, by this point, we have this diagonal going from the bottom left to the top right. And so we know what that diagonal adds up to. 22 plus 24 plus 26 is going to give us 72. So I'm just going to write a 72 down here. This is our target. All right, every row, every column, every diagonal is going to have to add up to 72. So at this point, all we have to do is find any time where we've got two entries in a row, column, or diagonal, and then figure out what the third one is. Right? Let's take a look at this first column, for instance. We already talked about how 22 plus 21 is 43. What do you have to add on to 43 in order to get 72? Well, that's just a 29. And of course, we can do 29 plus 24 plus 19. That's also going to give us a 72. This is a good way to check your work, by the way, right? Once you've got the numbers filled in, you can go through, if you have time and if you feel like it would help to double check all those results, you can add up every row, every column, and every diagonal and make sure that they add up to 72. Middle row, 21 plus 24 plus what equals 72? Well, there are a couple of ways we can do this, right? 21 plus 24 is 45, and then we add 27 onto it to get a 72. Here's what I want to show you. 24 is exactly a third of 72, right? And every row, column, and diagonal, because they add up to 72 and they all have three entries, their average is going to be 24. So I'm looking for this middle row to average a 24. Well, this is already 24, but this one is 3 less than 24. That means the other one is going to have to be 3 more than 24, which is the 27 that we already talked about. Let's use that same concept on this middle column just to make sure we understand what's going on, right? Remember, this middle column adds up to 72. The numbers average 24. Well, I've got a 24 here, but this 17 is too low by 7. So I'm going to need to have a third entry that is higher than 24 by 7 as well. 24 plus 7 gives us a 31. And you can check on your own. 17 plus 24 plus 31 does equal 72. The easy way to check it, of course, is to do exactly what we just did, is to say that 17 is 24 minus 7, 34 is 24 plus 7, and the minus 7 and the plus 7 cancel out, and I've basically got three 24 is here, and 3 times 24 is 72. Again, just check your work across each column down, across each row, down each column, and through each diagonal if you want to verify that all these numbers are 72. At this point, they're just asking us for the sum of the numbers that belong in the empty squares. So it's a matter of adding those up. Let's take a look at what we have and see if there are any tricks we can use to adding these up. 24, 26, 27, 29, and 31, right? So, you know, you can just put them all in a column and add them up, or you can do it mentally, maybe a little bit faster. 24 and 26, one of them is one more than 25, one of them is one less. So it's basically two copies of 25. That gives us a 50. 29 and 31, I've got one less than 30, one more than 30. So I basically have two copies of 30, which is going to give me a 60. That makes things a lot easier, right? I've got 110 between these two, and then I just add 27 onto it to get 137 as our final answer. And that's how it's done. Hi, everybody. This is Tim. Hope you're enjoying our videos. If so, you know what to do. Like, subscribe, turn on notifications, all that sort of thing. But what I'd really want to invite you to do is to send us an email at media@mathleague.org. Tell us which problems you'd like to see us cover next in our video series. Take care and see you in the next video.